Périgueux.
There is a Wednesday dark and deep, they cry, the Périgueux. What country folk from miles are who not fit to walk within? But for a' her mither's warning, she thronly wandered in, and quickly found herself at the dark hat of Périgueux. Ah, that day she wandered through the wild, deserted glen, till at last, but sair and weary, she decided to gang him. But syne she found a bonny burn wi' waters cool and deep, and resting on the grassy bank, she fell into a sleep. And in her dreams a young man came, wha took her by the hand, and led her to his castle and a far and distant land. He gave her wine, he kissed her lips, he stroked her bonny hair, and told her she would be his queen and his forever mare. Next he teened her round the waist and led her up the stairs, and showed her to the wedding bed with silks and linen fair. Sighing in her dream she felt a pain so sharp, but oh so sweet, it pierced her to the very core, but still she lay asleep. And to her senses she came round, the day was nearly done, her clothes were all in disarray, her maidenhead was gone. The lassie dressed so hastily and quickly hurried in, and cursed the day she fell asleep down in the Périgueux. Her feather ranted and he raged, her mother grat for shame, to hear what happened to her lass down in the Périgueux. But worse news was to follow on, as they were soon to learn, and run about the month of March, the lass brought forth a bairn. Her mother looked upon the bairn, her een grew wide with fear. This bairnie is a fairy lass, we darnie keep her here. For her feather is nae mortal man, he'll come to claim his ain, and tak the bairnie back wi' him into the Périgueux. And right enough, that very nicht, as the hour was growing late, the same young man she dreamed about came rattling at the gate. Come down the stairs, my bonny lass, and bring to me your bairn. Oh no, she said, you'll tak my babe and maybe dear's hern. Ach, the hern ye are, your family is the last thing on my mind, but I canna leave her here with you in this realm of mortal kind. For your life is but a season that flares briefly like a flame, and if I should leave her here with you, her life would be the same. The lassie handed over the bairn, tears dropped fae her een. Ach, you needna part wi' her, he said, if you will be my queen. Say farewell to your parents, for you'll nae see them again, and come awa' and bide wi' me doon in the Périgueux. Kind sir, my parents only leave to bide in Périgueux, for I could nae thole the thocht o' never seeing them again. Then farewell, lass, he said to her, I wish you very well, so before I tak my leave of you, your fortune I will tell. You will wed a wealthy man, a man both good and true, twa laddies and a lass you'll hae to bring great joy to you. But you must tell them a' this tale and warn them very plain, never venture in the woods nor sleep in Périgueux, for the folk that dwell in Fairy Glen will claim. friend.